states, living back in the time. TDE, it's the family, we them dominant dogs. Top tiering, when them comments evolve, we out for it all. Rock solid, he ain't dropping the ball. Prime time, who want it with us? Us. Got clarity, longevity, like bus and bus. Got too far in this to starve in this, and that's a no-no. If I'm hungry, then I'm hunting, always on the go-go.
Been a problem my whole life. Mama love when I'm living right. Daddy raised me, survive and fight. Now they watching me on prime time. Now they watching me on prime time. Now they watching me on prime time. Been a problem my whole life. Mama love when I'm living right. Daddy raised me, survive and fight. Now they watching me on prime time.
Well, we are about a $50 cab ride away from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford. Today, after a topsy-turvy opening weekend, it's on to week two, and we've got a good one here, as it'll be the San Francisco 49ers taking on the New York Jets. Two teams here, each off to 1-0 starts, as this one is underway on EA Sports. And no run back on the opening kickoff. It'll come out to the 25. Play fake here on first down. And he'll throw this one away, but I don't think he was out of the pocket. No, here comes the flag. We saw it too. Nobody in the vicinity of that throw, and that earns him the penalty.
Yeah, you've got to at least get it close enough to one of your own guys in order to dodge the penalty.
The yardage, and of course they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Flushed out right, and that's incomplete.
Well, partner, guaranteed they approach this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. It's taken to the 26. Following the punt return here, there's someone shaken up.
We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium.
Ready, can punt.
First down, this is McCaffrey. And good space to operate there as he takes this down inside the 35-yard line. First down, San Francisco, the pickup, 14 yards.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. When you talk about this Jets defense, they put together a strong effort last week in the win over the Bears, CD.
They forced 7 turnovers.
How many?
7.
7.
I mean, think about
7.
That number now. That's supposed to be a lucky number, right? Lucky for one side, unlucky for the other.
Here's 2nd and 10. It's going to be a gain of 6 on the keeper, but it leads to a 3rd down. This defense for the Jets, terrific last week in the season-opening victory.
And that's not the half of it. They forced 7 turnovers in that game, and I know we always talk about turnovers coming in bunches once you force the first one. But 7? That seems almost impossible, but we watched it happen.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Williams being motioned left. Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number 1. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
And he'll elect not to run with it. The fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line. Offense taking over for their next possession. And I would say they went 3 and out last time, but actually they didn't even get to 3 and out. Still a strange decision to us here in the booth.
Yeah, let's hope they don't go 1 and out, but maybe, possibly, let's try and think with them here. Try and play field position maybe, turn the ball over, put it in the hands of their defense, who knows?
You're a nice man. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2. You look at this Niner defense. They were very good in the win over Dallas a week ago.
I just consider myself fortunate that I'm not in charge of the offensive line. They gave up 7 sacks last week. And if things don't improve in this game, head coach isn't going to be looking at the offensive line. He's going to be looking at the offensive line coach. And that's when things get dicey.
On 1st and 10, it's Hall. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5, to about the 39. Ball on the 39. Here's the 2nd and 8. The give now to Abanacanda. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Still to go. 3rd down now. And they'll go again with Abanacanda. And they needed 2. They could only get 1. 4th down. They'll go for it. It's Abanacanda. And he's got the 1st down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert.
Brandon, fourth and one on their own side of the 50, and they decide to go for it. As a former defender, I take that personally. I can't believe they let them pick that up. They should have swarmed the line of scrimmage and stuffed that one.
Not surprised, though, because they told us about the supreme confidence they had in the O-line, and they were able to get that yard. So this drive going to continue following the conversion on fourth. Here's first and 10. On the handoff, Abanacanda. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. From the 46, here's second down at 7. Here's Abanacanda. Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about 5.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Move the chains, a gain of 7 on third down. The Jets at 1-0 on the year following the win in week 1. And they've gotten a pretty good deal from the schedule makers as well. Home dates in weeks 1 and 2.
And I would believe that they would need to take advantage of that, partner, because as you can imagine, the road dates will pile up later this season. So this is a great opportunity for them to put some early distance on the rest of the division and create a little bit of a cushion for them for later in the year.
Second and 7 operating from the 34. From the gun, here's Abanacanda. And he'll get a little over 2, maybe a full 3 down to the 32-yard line.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
They'll set up to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They converted twice on third down that drive already, but couldn't make it a third. We always talk about in-game adjustments. How about what the defense did there, able to shut them down on that attempt?
And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and 5. Back to throw. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with the football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Jets try it, but the fourth down play doesn't work. Well, their first fourth down attempt earlier was successful. This one backfires for a turnover on downs.
I like their aggressiveness. I like what they're doing. They got it the first time they went for it. Why not a second time? I don't think they'll be daunted from attempting it again. If you're on the defensive side of the ball, though, any fourth down stop is a big momentum play.
Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Now second and 9. Lance now to throw. He'll get this underneath to McCaffrey. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. The 49ers with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a first and 10. Lance looking to throw it. Another grab here for the dynamic Christian McCaffrey. It'll go as a gain of 4, and it's second down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays,
They run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
Second and six with the ball on the seven. Now a play fake. Lance. That is caught by the tight end, Kittle. Touchdown, 49ers. A great play there. His first touchdown of the new season. And they are able to add on to their advantage. Oh, and it's no good. He tugged it wide left. And that will keep our score right where it is. So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. A kind of a lucky break on the prior drive, Charles. The turnover on downs that the offense had didn't come back to bite them after the other side, their defense, came through, was able to hold them without any points.
I would agree with you, partner. A little bit of a lucky break indeed, but you know what they'd say to us? No luck, just pure skill. We rose to the challenge, and we didn't permit a score. That's how we roll.
Well, I'm kind of curious, Charles, if they might temper their aggressiveness now offensively if they get in that fourth down spot again.
Yeah, one would think so. Maybe because they held him, they might go for it again.
13 yards as they've got the connection working. His second catch in a row, first down. Looking to throw. Oh, he catches it off the tip. It wasn't even intended for him. 13-yard gain yet again, just like last play.
But when we see the ball tipped in the air, sometimes we get a little roll change, don't we? Because when it's in the air, sometimes the defensive back becomes the receiver. And in this case, the receiver looked like a defensive back, but ended up a receiver.
He caught it. It's a receiver. Hey, it worked out.
Worked out really well for them. But I'm telling you, the defensive guys.
Frustrated.
Oh, frustrated. They're going to catch it in film.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. They'll look to throw again. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch. Take the hit. And pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
19 life. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
They haven't been able to stop them so far this series, but getting a nice little stand from their defense now.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Back to throw again. Eluding the pressure right. And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. Decent gain on the scramble to six, but now it's fourth.
And defensively, they had an extra defensive back on the field, their nickel package, and it made a difference. All the receivers were blanketed, so he tried to run for it, but he came up just a bit short.
The offense going to stay out there. They've converted once, failed once. What can they do here on fourth down? Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And this is going to be recovered by a member of the offense, but whistles come in. Remember, on fourth down, that becomes a dead ball if anyone other than the fumbler himself recovers. So it'll come back to the spot of the fumble, and that will mean that's going to wind up being a turnover on downs. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated grooves. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Throwing now is Lance. Connects with Kittle underneath. They'll wind up getting just a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and 12.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well, because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Is Lance on third down. Flush to his right. That is caught. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. Give him 22 there on the third down conversion.
Now that's all about making something happen as a quarterback, because instead of forcing something on third down, how about him buying some time outside of the pocket, waiting for someone to come open? And when he did, he put it on him for a big play and a first down.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. In motion right, that's Williams. Lance now on first down. He'll get this out wide here to McCaffrey. Only able to gain a couple there, and it's second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
This is second and 8. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And strong running there as he's across midfield and down to the 49. A gain of 10 and a 49er first down. Veteran running back like him, we've seen a lot of those chunk carries in his career.
And that's why you don't just look at his birth certificate and decide when a guy is done, right? Because you know as well as I do, in this league, as soon as you hit 30, they're looking to let you go if you're a running back. Sometimes there's a little tread left on the tires.
On first down, Lance. Got a man right side, it's McCaffrey. Down the sideline he goes. And finally taken down at the 15. It's a gain of 35.
That's why you call a screen. You want to catch a defense overcommitting. Plenty of space available, and that matched up perfectly. What a convoy he got downfield to pick up big yardage on that play.
So after the big play, look at this. All the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Tackle on that play by Quinnen Williams.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Here's second and 7. Working from the gun, Lance. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. That leads us to a first and goal. It's a pickup of 8. Now a timeout called for by the offense as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number 1.
Let's go. Blue 32.
Here we go. Let's go, let's go.
Ready.
And a quick throw here. That's complete. Touchdown. A great effort there. As the first half is winding down, and the 49ers will extend their lead here just before halftime. This time, the extra point up and good. And that could be important as that makes this a 16-point lead. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fair catch, going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And the Niners get there and bring him down. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half.
That's a pretty darn good start to his season, huh? A sack in the opener, adds a second one here. That tells you about his offseason. He came in determined to have a big year, and it's paying off.
Single receiver, hey, you're on
three, three.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
That's a good bounce back play right there after taking a sack on first down. Didn't quite get it to the marker, but now they're in a much better spot for a third and short yardage call. If you're the offensive coordinator, you like looking at that section a heck of a lot better than trying to figure out third and long.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. So much for the run on third and one. Instead, it's a big chunk in the pass game. First down.
And that might be exactly what they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given them much to cheer for so far. And never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. They'll throw now on the final play. He's got a man that's caught left sideline. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. And how about this line out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. It's the 49ers out in front, and they will get the football first as well as we are back and started in the second half. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Now second and three. Samuel going to go in motion right. Another run with McCaffrey on second down. And he works his way free all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone. 46 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but There are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Forced out to his left. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. Defensively, celebration time, because they finally forced an incompletion. He was perfect throwing the ball to that point.
Yeah, but from his viewpoint, they didn't force the incompletion. He just missed. That's how hot he is right now, and that's how he wants to continue to throw the ball.
Second down, McCaffrey. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. That'll back them up 2 yards and also bring up fourth.
And that's what this defense is going to need to do more in the second half. Good pressure that time, forces some indecision in the backfield. He's going to wind up being taken down for a nice loss.
And his kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further. And right now, Charles, this is about building that lead little by little, and they're able to do just that.
And it gets them past the key number of 16, so this is now a 3-score lead. Not time to exhale just yet. But that might prove to be an important 3 points before things are said and done.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Yeah, he'll fight for a couple as the tackle is made at about the 32. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40 before being taken down. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards. Work to do here to avoid falling to 1-1, but this is first and 10 right now. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. They'll motion the tight end across the formation. On play action, they'll throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
That's a big force incompletion there to bring up third and long, and this defense can still salvage a little momentum by forcing them to kick a field goal, because just a few plays ago, they looked like they were headed towards the end zone.
Hey, check that, street.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. This pass out wide to Hall. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. Still just a third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. They only needed a few inches, and they didn't get much more than that. But by about the width of a shoelace, they convert on fourth down. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll run with Hall, and they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3.
This is a critical sequence here for this offense. Things really haven't gone their way so far. This could be their chance to get back into it, but they've got to find a way to punch this ball in.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. He'll look to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. Taking in left side, it's Wilson. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. A 4-yard pickup, not enough. Fourth down.
Well, it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
The offense stays out there. A big challenge here from this far back, but they're going for it on fourth and goal. They'll set up a throw. And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with a football. They can't hook up here on the fourth down pass attempt. And this long drive is going to wind up yielding nothing. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. Your 3 scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in 2-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call 4-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
Second and 10. In motion left comes Williams. Lance with a tap forward on the jet sweep. Oh, and that is well read defensively. A great job of setting the edge, and that little touch pass is going to turn into a loss. Well, I think the hope is, you know, with a touch pass like that, that maybe you catch the defense off guard, but they were all over that one.
And it is the kind of play that works better against certain defenses. And this clearly was the wrong one to run into. Really nice job getting him down behind the line of scrimmage.
As they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. This offense so far on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is going to be third and 13. Williams, a man in motion right. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost 2, and it brings up 4.
Well, that was a 3rd and long run, and to me, that was just a wave the white flag kind of a situation. Obviously, they don't want to risk the chance of throwing it downfield and risking a turnover in this section of the field.
Here comes the 49ers punter now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. And he's able to get it out of there, and this is a pretty good kick. Hardman on the return. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And the Jets will have a short field to work with as they take over first and 10. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll drop to throw. He dumps this one off here to Hall. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. So 5 yards here, five on the play. And that'll bring up second down.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Check, 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 check. Hurry, hurry.
Second and five. Escaping the pressure right. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down. He'll drop to throw. Oh, and a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch. Here's second and three. They're going to look to throw. They go with a shuffle pass, and it's complete. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. So the completion good for just three. And they'll be faced with a third and inches.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
On the move to his left. And that is caught. But he will come down out of bounds, says the side judge. Incomplete.
Well, I kind of got to give him credit. Another incompletion there, yes, but he's still trying to make plays outside the pocket.
Yeah, he's been hemmed in for much of the game. How about him getting outside there? And that's what you want to see from your quarterback. He's not giving up on this game, so every other player on the field has to say to himself, I can't give up either.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Touchdown, Jets. Garrett Wilson, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Jets are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still two scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
They're going to keep it on the ground, and he's going to get in. So they're back within 11. And so they run it in on the two-point try. And it's so often, Charles, we talk about from the offense's perspective what you do on the two-point conversion. How about the defense? How do they play run versus pass?
It's really difficult for them because I think most teams want to play for the pass. That's what they see most teams do. And so are you able to mass enough people inside if the team decides to run it? Very difficult. I think what you're seeing a lot more now, people blitzing the two-point conversion. They want you to make a quick decision and make it right now.
There, the offense wins the battle for two. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They've been pretty anemic on this side of the football in the second half, just 3 points, and you just saw the touchdown go the other way, so it's a two-score game. We're not done here yet.
I think everyone's on the edge of their seats now because they're anticipating what's coming, and I sense that everyone in the stadium knows they need to keep it on the ground. So if you're going to do that, hope the quarterback is stretched a little bit. Some bootlegs, right? Some fakes inside, getting out to the perimeter. Those might be open for him.
Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. And they'll send Williams in motion right. Second down and right back to McCaffrey. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. Another 6-yard carry, same as last play. First down.
Well, I don't think there's any question, Brandon, at this stage. the stop troops, the defensive guys, they've got to use their three timeouts here. They've got to stop them and get the ball back.
Yeah, if you're in that 2-3 score deficit window that they're in now, you got to get it ASAP.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Stop them, use your timeouts. Easier to move the ball on offense without timeouts than to stop them on defense without using them.
Lance now on first down. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. It'll go as a first down for San Francisco on a pickup of 16. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it, and they got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down if they want to take another shot and try.
Now Lance unable to escape, and down he goes. They'll wind up losing eight on the sack there, and it's second down.
Well, remember, they had the nice gain on the previous play, but they just gave a lot of it back right there on that sack.
Yeah, they get the sack, get back some real estate. Felt like the type of play that could spark a defense and swing some momentum. Almost felt like a take that type of a play, didn't it, partner?
Whistles now in a timeout defensively. So a wise move as they'll use the first of their timeouts to force one more play before the two-minute warning. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. They'll try and burn some clock now with McCaffrey. And he'll take it across midfield down into Jet territory. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here.
Try to take this home. They'll run.
No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave them with a fourth down. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining.
They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL, and he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time, so make sure you get in shape.
On that punt, we've got a man shaken up.
We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium.
This is first and 10.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive.
And check down complete to Hall.
And they'll be stopped at the 28. On a play that started at the 14, they pick up 14. They need a touchdown, the two-point conversion, and a field goal. Pretty good start to the drive, though.
Yeah, good start to the drive, but the urgency has to really be increased by both the players on the field and everyone on the sidelines. Got to make sure everyone is up and into this game.
That's caught by Wilson,
and he'll go out near midfield at the 49. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
One timeout at their disposal, but more pressing is the need for two scores, obviously. Here's first and 10.
Now back to throw. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it.
Picked off by Emmanuel Forbes. And the 49ers are going to take over once again, and they'll have it at their own 8-yard line.
So many times we end a game, and as we're recapping it, we're talking about what offenses did and how they won the game. Let's flip this one over. The defense, they frustrated the offense the entire ball game. That's why they're walking out of here with a victory.
And they're going to love to walk out of here with that as their final act, that interception. Good way for them to end it.
We've got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down.
And he'll be out of bounds up past the 10-yard line. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Lance with a tap forward on the jet sweep.
And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line.
This defense not fooled one bit on that touch pass.
And this has become one of those kind of in vogue plays, you know, kind of like the shuffle pass was a few years ago. This one never got off the ground, but you understand why a lot of teams are running it. These wide receivers, a lot of them, they run like running backs with the ball in their hands.
He's got a man complete. Still going inside the 20. Touchdown, 49ers. Jameson Williams, 89 yards. And the 49ers are on their way to a 2-0 start. Moody good with the extra point.
And the lead is up to 18 now.
So after the made field goal by Moody, he's back out to kick this one away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive.
They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something."
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. He got 29 yards that time. They'll look to throw now on first down. And he's got his man on the out route. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An out cut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
Second down and a little more than a yard here. One final shot. They'll look to throw. One last shot at the end zone.
And that will be incomplete. They were going for a consolation TD, but it was not to be. And time has run out now on this game.
So the victory here for San Francisco, and I think the game balls need to be distributed on the defensive side of the football, and I bet that you would agree.
Yeah, if you hold a team under 10 points, that's a job well done. Really well done. So I would say game balls for every starter and every key player who participated in this game.
Now, see, I only like one game ball.
You're
handing out multiple, although I set you up by saying game balls plural.
Yeah,
but I
like where we're going with this, though. You say one to represent, like, the best player of all of that. And I say multiples so that you keep everyone motivated and involved.
You're a man of the people.
I'm a man of the people. I thought I was the only child.
You get a game ball, and you get a game ball. Game balls for everybody. So for San Francisco, it's a dream start. Two wins in two early road games. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the Jets, they'll fall to 1-1. And they'll try to get back on track next week as they head up to Orchard Park to take on the Buffalo Bills.